Hey guys, I'm real excited to bring you the Unitronic intake installation today. This is a long time coming. The timing just worked out right between John at Unitronic and me, and we finally got this deal taken care of. I did not get this free. I did get a very good deal on it, so I'm looking forward to installing it. Everything looks normal to me. One thing that stood out a little bit is how small this filter is. I'm just used to seeing ones that are twice as round, you know? And it looks a lot bigger in the pictures, but that's a pretty small filter. It has a lot of depth to it, which gives a lot of surface area, but I've just never seen a filter that skinny. It's kind of weird. Looking forward to installing it. I gotta first get all my stock stuff off. Let's rifle through the stock intake removal first. I'll remove my SA filter tube, my MAF, take my stock hose off. Allen for your stock box. Get that loosened up. Top box cover. Squeeze these in to get this out. Your bottom box cover. Take your flathead around the U-bend here. That's how I do it. Get the U-bend out. And a little more on the Allen. Careful lifting this part by your hose down there, and the stock box is out. Next, we're going to take out the rear tube. I'm going to start with a T30 for your one bracket bolt here. It's a little warm, but I should be able to do it. Too excited to get this installed. I can't wait for the car to cool down. Maybe I'll let it cool after I get this stuff off. So carefully remove this bolt, you don't want to drop it. Burn your fingers. There's that. I have a regular clamp down here, so I'm just going to use a flathead to remove that clamp. Then I also have to remove the whole hose and bottom clamp, so that'll be a little more tricky. Now you have this hose here. This is very tricky to get off and easy to break. And you just got to squeeze certain sides of it. So take your time on this one. I wouldn't put wedge screwdrivers in there. I've snapped the clips before. This one has been off before, so I'm just going to work at it carefully and make sure I don't break a clip. And like 10 to 15 minutes later, I finally got it. I actually use wedge little toothpicks under a couple of the sides to hold it all together. It's really hard to get all four of these clips at once, so you can pull it out, but I didn't break it. I stayed patient and I got it out properly. Sometimes people ask me, how do I get to these really hard to get clamps? Well, I use this wide spark plug wire puller. On the top one, you can see it's real easy. It has an angle there. This bottom one is a little trickier to get to. I could probably get it. I can grab both sides and I can just hold it straight, but I'm gonna need two hands to do that. Let me get this stock hose off. So this first hose was easy enough to get on. Nice snug fit, not too tight. And I got my clamp head right where my thumb is, so I can go in a nice side angle here and tighten this lower clamp. People have said make sure every hose is on fully, so I make sure it's fully bottomed out on there, just for fitment purposes and stuff that we'll look at later. So I'm ready to tighten this clamp, the first step. I like to take a mirror around the backside here and just make sure I have a nice even bead around the hose there. Make sure the clamp's nice and even. The mirror there, you can see a real nice bulge. The clamp is nice and tight. It's not ripping anything, but it's definitely tight enough. Next, we're going to put on the big clamp here. Well, the big hose or pipe. I already have a clamp on that hose, the upper clamp, and I'm just going to have to wiggle and mess with it here. I got it with two hands. Actually, it went in good. This clamp is a lot easier. The bottom one, it was so stiff, I couldn't even turn it with my finger. It was like brand new. This one, at least I can turn with my finger. So I'm going to go ahead and get this cinched up even and put in my bolt over here. I have to mention this here, it was a perfect fit. super snug, like OEM, just snapped right in and locked in place. So I hopefully this won't leak like the APR second pipe. We all know about it, it's no secret. But this one locked in so perfectly snug, I think this one will probably be pretty good. Bracket lined up pretty good. So far, so good. And I won't know how it's going to fit until I'm done. It's just kind of strange angles, but no problem. Nothing hits anywhere. So I'm going to tighten up this bolt right there. And I'm going to tighten up my clamp, and then we'll continue. Make sure you wiggle this clamp right up to the top here. Watch out for clearance if the clamp can't get up, or right down here, but it can. This hose is underneath these pipes, so there's plenty of room. But see, I got the clamp right up at the tip, so make sure you have it nice and high. If you go too low, you don't want to get any leaks there. As I get further along in the install, I remembered I forgot to remove this vent with the two Torx stuff over here, so let me pull this vent out next. Here's something I didn't know about it. I'm putting on my heat shield here. You, of course, got your standard screw and your screw that goes into the stock sleeve here. Looks like you got a third screw point. I never knew that. So I also have to take out this battery tray screw and put it back in. That's three mounting points. That's going to be really secure. I like it. Okay, I got the three screws in. They did include a new bolt here, so you don't have to use your stock one out of your little airbox grommet. And I got all the screws in. And I'm leaving it loose. I don't have the instructions with me. I'm just kind of winging it. So rather than have to do stuff twice, I'm going to get a clip next for this hose down here. See, another really nice touch. You got this hose rubbing here. See, this would be a problem. They include this sweet little bracket. You're going to go up underneath, and it's going to keep it off of here just like that. It's going to be really sweet. So I'm going to go ahead and get that bracket in. That bracket was really good. It's really hard to get in the hole, which means it's very snug and secure. And you could see down here, look at that. You got the hose separated from your metal. It's a really nice touch that you usually only see with companies like NewSpeed. So this is a really nice intake from Unitronic to include those little details. We're getting there. Next thing to do, I'm going to remove the MAF from the stock airbox. This should go without saying, but you do want your clamps all facing the right way. I'm going to have my U facing where I can read it, and my clamps on the battery side, because I can already see it has an angle this direction, and some people will get a little valve cover rubbing here. So the clamps, there's definitely going to be more room on this side, so I'm going to have all my clamps along the battery side of the hoses here. It's kind of something funny to note. Some of the other stage 2 pipes, you always have the notorious rubbing and sitting on your brake line. I got like 2 inches here in gap. Now it does sit kind of high, which is strange, but I want to see the final product, see how it ends up. But you definitely have no clearance problems at your brake booster, at your brake reservoir on this one. Got it mocked up a bit. Now I'm going to tighten my heat shield bolts to start with. So I already test fit my engine cover, and I can see light through it. I have a millimeter, which is perfect. So the first trick I did, I bottomed this fully out, tightened this clamp. Then I pushed this one onto this pipe, and I pushed it all the way on where I could hear the metal even touch, maybe back it off a hair, but it's not going to vibrate probably anyway. But you want to push this hose on as far as you possibly can. It probably goes all the way down to here. Don't just push on a tip or everything's going to be off. So I'm just working my way from the back, as we saw, all the way up here. Push this all the way down. And gonna just tighten up these gaps and then get these clamps tightened here. If you really had some rubbing here, you just couldn't get it going right, you can always trim off like just that bit I've exposed, like an eighth of an inch off this hose, and it would just be just enough to clear it. Still worst case, but I mean, with a razor blade, very carefully, you could do it clean. I don't need to do that, I don't think. I'm gonna wait till the final results here, but that's something you could do if you just really want it perfect there. Every clamp is perfectly tight. You can see I kind of got a more straight angle than some people's I've seen. It kind of comes out and around. I've seen that. I don't know why. Mine goes a little bit, but it's pretty straight, which should be good. I want to give you the proof right here so there's no speculation. I have no rubbing whatsoever. I'm pretty stoked. I was a little bit worried about that. I thought I might have to modify this hose a little bit, but you can see the light right there. It is not touching the engine cover anywhere, so it fits even better than I expected. Let's go to the filter next. Filter is a very easy fit. All these hoses are easy to get on. You don't have to struggle with them, soak them in hot water. Everything was a really nice fit, honestly. Every hose was perfect. Every clamp was perfect. I don't know about this metal line. See, I was getting my U. Getting my U perfectly straight up and down because I'm so psycho. But then it shows this metal line. I think I'm going to twist it. I'll never see that U. It doesn't matter. I will see this silver line. I want to go ahead and turn it around so it's not visible. Wow. You know, now I'm not surprised on why half of the forums and enthusiasts run this intake. It's really amazing. You know how picky I am. This could be the most perfect product I've ever installed. Honestly, I couldn't find one flaw. I mean, that's super unusual. I was trying to find something I could just mention. It's kind of, people look for that. That's why they watch these videos, but I cannot find a single flaw, man. That is incredible. Let's go ahead and finish up with our CBFA filter on this excellent install. So obviously it's not gonna fit here. This piece is twistable. So you can either go here, which I'll probably do, because I'm gonna tie wrap it to that hose there. They included the two tie wraps. And I wouldn't go this way. It'd be too far into this thing. So I'm gonna twist it this way. You wanna be very careful doing this twist. In fact, I'm gonna put the camera down and use two hands. You don't wanna crack this, the most critical thing, but this does twist in the hose. So I'm gonna grab the hose with one hand and put my whole fist over this to hold these clips secure, and I'm going to twist it so it's 90 degrees. All right, I got one flaw. I got you, Uni. This tie wrap is too short to go around this tube and around this, so I'm going to go get some of my long ones. Maybe they want you to chain two together, I don't know. I didn't read the directions, so it could be my stupid mistake, but I'm just going to get my big tie wrap and tie wrap it here. The small one just doesn't reach. You know, as I'm putting it here, I'm realizing I think that's too high. I don't know if that's gonna hit the hood. I can probably aim it down here. I should probably go open the damn instruction book, to be honest. But I think it would actually fit down here. Just gotta see about clearance right there on that bracket. Let me go check it out here and get this finished up. No, they don't mention that in the direction, so I'm just gonna play around with it. It definitely won't fit facing down there because I still got way too much gap before I tie wrap it. It's just not gonna fit that way. So it does aim up. I guess I'll just check out everybody else's later, but I'm gonna install it that way for now. Also wanted to note how easy this goes in. Perfect. I did it with one hand. Really good fit. I think that's it. I don't really want to have it aimed this way because it could be here. Make it stick out even higher because the front of the hood goes up. So I think this is my best angle for now. Plenty of clearance. We're all done with the install. I'm going to take it for a ride. Don't forget to connect your MAF harness up. As an extra bonus for me, I want to tie wrap this harness right there. Just so it doesn't bounce around and stuff on the pipe. I'm just going to tie wrap it right to the pipe. To make it real clean. So the kind of job this would normally, you could probably do it in 30 minutes, but I took an hour and 15 minutes just paying attention to every clamp, everything we got there. So I did get my tire up there. I'm gonna swivel it around so the little nub isn't visible from the top, and then it should be ready to start up. I'm gonna let it idle for 30 seconds a minute, like some of the intakes recommend. Just let it get used to it. You can see on the stock one, it's big at the 3-inch, it shrinks and it gets smaller and smaller as it goes down. This, of course, is different. It isn't really different because it's just having the reducer in a different spot. The reducer is on the hose. But this stays a lot bigger all the way through. I can see how one might lose a little low end with this intake. It's so big and beefy, so much air to fill. But most people say it's barely noticeable, and the sound and high perform and the top end is well worth it. But that's a pretty thick pipe there. That's pretty beefy. Don't use a microfiber to try and clean it. It's sort of like rough texture, sandpaper sort of thing, and it got bits of lint all over it. So, I don't know how you'd clean it. You can probably tell me, but don't use one of these cheap microfiber cloths because I got all these little threads that I just had to clean off. I also turned the U so it's facing upward and readable. Nice little touch there because that one is visible. Let's do the first startup. I haven't even taken it out yet. I always like to give you the true first experience. I'm gonna let this idle for a minute and not waste camera time. All right, we're leaving. Hear that hiss? It was kind of windy, but I got a killer blow off. I've never even heard that on a GTI before. Oh, that's cool. I'm gonna have to sit here for a sec. What I found with, I've tried a lot of stubbies and long intakes. I find the long intakes give a better torque and build up. And the shorter stubby ones, they respond quick, but they don't build up torque and power is what I've seen. So the longer tubed intakes are what I prefer. Sort of like I had a P-Flow with an Apexi that had a longish tube. And this one, of course, has a very long tube. It's already not as loud as I thought, which is probably good, but it's a lot of cool sounds that I'm looking forward to trying out here. Well, that's a nice sound and blow off. I kind of miss that on some of the intakes I've had. To be honest, guys, I don't feel any low end loss myself. So far, I've been waiting for it. I've been trying to feel it. I don't feel any low end loss on this thing. This is stage 2, as you know, Unitronic, stage 1 DSG software. No cat back yet, but it's always on my mind. I'm always thinking about it. Oh, I like it a lot. I don't say that too often on my first, right away. I just already love it. I guess I do say that in every review, so you're probably laughing at me, but I'm pretty excited about this mod. It's not as loud as I thought, which I'm very happy about. And it fits perfectly, so there's nothing gnawing at me as I know it's in there. And it sounds good. I don't feel any low-end loss. I can't really find a flaw with this thing. Some people said it was real loud. I'm kind of disagreeing. I can just hear hopefully you can hear me with the wind. I got a microphone at my collar. Some people said it's super loud. I don't find that. I can just barely hear the whine of the turbo. I wouldn't have minded more, but the turbo isn't quite as loud as some people have said it is. It all depends on your setup, I guess. A lot of people may disagree with this, but I think the APR Carbonio is a lot louder than this. That's my experience. Listen to my Carbonio video. It's huffing and puffing. It's like Darth Vader. This is nothing like that. This is not as loud at all. This is smoother. That one's a very sucky sound, no pun intended. It just sucks in and out. I like this open air. You get less of that big huff puff sound. So it's 100% clear to me that the APR intake is louder than this one. Now, most people disagree with me on the forums. That's fine. I'm just going with everything I've personally tried and driven, and that's how I feel. Of course, I can make it blow off if I want. That's pretty easy. Let's try this. Oh, that's some killer sound, man.